I'm Maile Ohye. I've been at Google now for over 6 years, working with search and with webmaster tools. I'd like to welcome you to my home. Let's chat about pagination and SEO. For today's agenda, we'll first start with some paginated content examples. Then we'll get into some of the negative side effects of pagination and why you as a webmaster might want to make some effort as to not dilute your indexing properties and to show better results to users. Then we'll cover your configuration. And this comes in two parts. For those of you webmasters with paginated content and a view all page available, and then for those of you webmasters that have paginated content but without a view all page. So there's gonna be two types of configurations there. Then we're gonna step back a little bit and talk about what Google's doing to help users with paginated content and webmasters as well. And then last, given your configuration, whether you have a view all page available or you have no view all page available, we'll look at the options that you have for your paginated content. So let's go ahead and start with some paginated content examples. Paginated content exists throughout the web, and I'm going to cover two of the most common cases. One is a paginated article. So let's say you go to your favorite content site and you see the breaking news story. New studies prove that cookies are superior nutrition to vegetables. And that would be quite the story. But your favorite site might not put this all on one page, but instead paginated into several component pages. Now this one article has become three. And this is an example of paginated content articles. Another example of pagination is for things like a product category, like what you would see on your favorite e-commerce site. So let's say this webmaster is selling shapes. They are selling six types of shapes, but rather than have it all on one page, they've divided it into two component pages, both of them with shapes, creating pagination again. So two common ways are with paginated content articles and with paginated product categories. Now, what are some of the negative side effects of this? Well, there's a couple. So I'd like to highlight two, the first being that indexing properties, like links and anchor text, can be diluted into the different component URLs rather than being consolidated to the one article or to the one product category. So that's one of the negative side effects. The other is that the most relevant page in the series might not be reflected in search results. So if you're the webmaster for this e-commerce site, you might want users to be sent to page one, say, of your series. But because search engines see this pagination as three separate entities, searchers might be sent to a different page that might not be the most relevant. So those are a few of the negative side effects of pagination. Now let's talk more about your situation and the configuration you have on your site. We're going to look at this in terms of two different types of configurations. One is with a view all page available, and the other is with no view all page available. Now, if your site has paginated content with a view all page available, there are a couple of things you want to make sure you test for. One is make sure that you have still decent latency on your site, meaning that if a user clicks on the view all version, that it doesn't take them 15 seconds to load because it's such a long article or it's so many products, but that they still have a good experience. Say the page only takes 4 seconds to load. The second thing to check for, if you have a view all page available, is to make sure that the page remains easily navigable, meaning that users can still find the content that they want or the particular product that they want by easily scrolling or viewing headings. So that's the configuration of a view all page available. And then obviously, without a view all page available, it's fairly straightforward. So think about your site and in terms of what configuration you have. But before we go there, let's take a step back and talk a little bit about what Google's doing. We're, of course, always working to improve the experience for searchers. And one thing that we found through testing is that our searchers prefer seeing the view all page in their search results opposed to an individual component page. And one reason for this might be because of latency. So if you take search results and you click on a result to a view all page, well, that might take, say, 3 seconds to load that article, that new studies prove that cookies are superior nutrition to vegetables. That might might be 3 seconds. But on the other hand, searchers were less happy when search results took them to just page one of the article. While that might have just had 2 seconds of latency and then the page loaded, every time that user wanted to click next to read more of the article, it caused some additional load time. So because of this latency and other reasons, searchers prefer the view all page. So given this knowledge, one of our engineers on indexing, Benjia Lee, actually came out with a new feature in October of 2011. This is, when we detect that a paginated series also contains a view all version, we're now making a larger effort to return the view all page in search results when appropriate. So that's great for searchers. And what's even better for webmasters is that while we detect this view all page, we'll also still consolidate indexing properties like links to the view all page. So again, this is good for searchers and good for you as webmasters for all that indexing consolidation. Now let's talk about some of the options that you have as a webmaster with paginated content. We're first going to look at the situation where webmasters have paginated content and a view all page available. But for those of you that have no view all page available, it's still good if you pay attention because some of these options will apply to you as well. So, okay, you have a site with paginated content and a view all page. You have three good options. First, you can leave as is. There's nothing that you have to do if you have other priorities on your site. Paginated content exists throughout the web, and search engines will continue to do an even better job of handling it. And as I mentioned earlier, if you have a view all page available, Google will automatically try to detect that, send searchers there, as well as consolidate your indexing properties. So option one is a very solid option. But you also have a second option. The second option is to actually use rel canonical to explicitly hint to Google what is your view all page. So while we try to detect it algorithmically, you can also tell us by writing rel canonical on your component pages to your view all version. And this is kind of a more explicit hint to us about how your site is configured. With the rel canonical, as many of you already know, we'll of course consolidate the indexing properties from the component pages with the canonical version. So things like links will also be transferred. And then of course, we'll send users to the view all page. So that's option number two. The last option is actually done by two of our engineers, Joachim and Benjia. And what this is using the standard HTML markup of rel next and rel prev on the component pages in your series to signal to Google that these are individual pages, but they all belong to one series. So by adding this rel next and rel prev markup, you connect these individual components into one. You can do this by adding rel next to page one, and then rel prev and rel next to page two, all the way to the last page, which only includes a rel prev. And then of course, on your view all page, nothing is needed. Rel next and rel prev is standard HTML markup, and it's been around for years. But now Google is using this markup for webmasters to let us know about their paginated content. So let me explain some ways that rel next and rel prev work. With rel next and rel prev, much like you see with something like rel canonical, we'll actually consolidate indexing properties from the component pages of the series. And in addition, unlike rel canonical that only shows the view all page in search results, with rel next and rel prev, we're going to override that behavior and send users to only one of the component pages. Most likely, this will be page one, because commonly that's the most relevant page. So now if you have, say, that product category, selling shapes, if you use the rel next and rel prev markup, it'll tell us that these two pages belong to one series, and then most commonly we'll send users to page one. Know that rel next and rel prev is a strong hint. It's not a mandate by any means. The last thing I want to say about rel next and rel prev is that component URLs in a series should be consistent with their parameters. So let's take the article of new studies prove that cookies are superior nutrition to vegetables. Now let's say that these pages contain a session ID. All of these values for rel prev and rel next should also contain the session ID. And this is because our indexing team looks to actually link every page in a series with what was declared previous and what was declared next. And when they do that, they want to make sure, say you're on page 2, that the rel prev, that states rel prev is page 1 and SID equals 1, 2, 3, they will go to that URL, but that URL actually has to list page 2 with the same SID. And that's how we can link every page in the sequence. So be sure to keep parameters throughout your entire series. So let's recap those three options. If you have a view all page available, you can leave as is. You can also explicitly state rel canonical to your view all page, or you can override the view all page behavior by adding rel next and rel prev. By adding rel next and rel prev, you will help us consolidate component pages in the series, but instead of sending users to a view all page, we'll then send searchers to one component page, most likely page 1 of your series. Now let's talk about the configuration with no view all page available. So for those of you webmasters that have paginated content and no view all page, you have two options. First, of course, you can leave as is, that's perfectly fine. And then your second option is also to use rel next and rel prev. Again, by using rel next and rel prev, it connects the component pages in the series and consolidates indexing properties and helps us to send searchers to the most relevant page, which is likely the first page of the series. Now I'm going to beat you to the punch and ask one of the most commonly asked questions about rel canonical as well as rel next prev, and that is, why rel next and rel prev for a paginated series rather than rel canonical to page 1? I bet you were thinking that. The answer is that rel canonical is for duplicate content. So let's take that article, let's say page 2 of the article, Cookies Are Superior Nutrition. If this page actually has a session ID attached, then it can list as the canonical the same version, the duplicate version, but without a session ID, because rel canonical is for duplicate content, or it's for content which is a superset. So here we have page 1, page 2, and page 3, all linking to the canonical version being the view all version. And that's perfectly fine as well. The thing about rel canonical is that it only indexes content from the canonical version. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. If we have page 2 and page 3, page 2 says cookies are superior nutrition, and page 3 says to vegetables. But they both add rel canonical just to page 1, and Google's index will then cluster page 1, page 2, and page 3 all together, but the only thing that we'll have indexed is the content from page 1, the canonical version. So our index will actually contain new studies prove that. And now by using this rel canonical incorrectly, this webmaster has totally lost the content, cookies are superior nutrition, and to vegetables. So that's why rel canonical doesn't work in this case. But rel next prev works for a series or a sequence of content. So let's take those two paginated examples again. By using rel next and rel prev, we'll actually, in Google's index, mark it as a series, but we'll have page 1, page 2, and page 3 all indexed separately. So in our index, we know page 1 refers to new studies prove that, page 2, cookies are superior nutrition, and page 3, to vegetables. And all three pages will be indexed and marked as one series. So that's the big difference between rel canonical and rel next prev. So something to note is that rel canonical can actually be used alongside rel next prev. So let's take a look at page 2 again, and this time it has a session ID. This URL can actually list both a canonical version without a session ID, as well as a rel prev and rel next with, of course, the same parameters, including that session ID. So now let's recap your new pagination toolbox, starting with Google. We have two new features for you. First, we're making a better effort to detect a view all page and then send searchers to that preferred view all version. The second feature is if you want to actually even override that behavior. So for those of you with a view all page available or without, if you add markup with rel next and rel prev, it signals to Google that these are component pages in a series, will then consolidate indexing properties and send searchers to the most relevant page, most likely page one. Now let's get into the types of configurations you have available. So recapping, if you have a view all page available, you have three options. You can leave as is, you can use rel canonical on your component pages pointing to your view all page, or you can override all the view all detection by adding rel next and rel prev, telling us that these component pages belong to a series, and I'd like you, Google, to send searchers to the most relevant individual page, again, likely page one. Now, the other part of the pagination toolbox is for those of you with no view all available. And you have two options. Of course, you can leave exactly as is, or again, you can use rel next and rel prev. This helps you to consolidate all the component pages into one series and send searchers to the most relevant page. So the great thing about these pagination features is that I've been at Google long enough to see the infancy from when the webmaster community was talking to us about issues with pagination until now when we have more features available to you. So thank you so much to all of you for your helpful feedback and for being part of this webmaster community. For more information on pagination, here are some links available, and you can of course join us at the Webmaster Central blog or in the Webmaster discussion forum. Thanks for your time.